All right, welcome back inside our proactive newsroom. And joining me now is Christopher Moreau. He's the CEO of Algernon Pharmaceuticals. And Chris, it's good to have you back again. How are you?
I'm good today, Steve. How are you doing today?
Doing awesome. Very well. Thank you. And a really interesting news release out from the company today. We've talked about the study that you want to do using DMT. And now there's a process where you have to create this compound that's going to be used, and you've been able to complete that. So just give everyone a bit of an update on where you're at as far as that's concerned.
Yeah, it's a very big step. For those that know, all psychedelic drugs are heavily controlled substances. They can't, you just can't hire a company to make them. And so we identified a Canadian company, Dalton Pharma, a number of months ago. They had experience making psychedelic compounds. They had the correct licenses from Health Canada. We reached out to American companies, European. We reached out to some suppliers in China. I mean, the Chinese suppliers, they couldn't even talk about it in the email. That's how restricted that country is in terms of making these compounds. And it's because of the government regulations. And what's happened is it makes it very difficult even for researchers to look into it. We got very lucky. We got our approvals. Dalton started manufacturing the process months ago. And as of this morning, we've announced that we have our what's known as a CGMP supply. That's clinical grade. Now we have enough drug to run, we believe, all of our phase one, obviously, but we have enough compound to run phase two trials as well. So this is very big news for the company.
Yeah. You've also hired a couple of people that will be working on this as well, and two well-known UK researchers.
Right. Dr. Rudd and Dr. Simister, these are what I would call stroke heavy hitters from the UK. We were introduced to these gentlemen on our last trip to the UK when we met Hammersmith Medicine. And we do plan on running our phase two trials in the UK. And if you just, you know, we did highlights of their CVs. And by looking at their backgrounds, you know, these gentlemen have devoted, and Tony, who is, Anthony has retired now, but Rob Simister is working. They've devoted their lives to stroke research and to, as clinicians, helping people. And I believe that they see the real potential that DMT could actually be a therapeutic, and they're willing to help us investigate it for stroke. So it was, I'm grateful that these gentlemen are on board.
And just to, I know we talked about this in the past, but just to confirm with everyone, sort of the time frame on all of this, now that you've got this phase one and phase two medical grade supply, so right. You can begin right away?
Well, so we have met with the UK MHRA, that's like the FDA from the United Kingdom. We announced by news release, we had a pre-meeting with them. They were very agreeable with our phase one plan. We will be applying for phase one approval. We think that will happen very quickly. And we're planning to start that phase one before the end of January next month. That should probably take, you know, 3 or 4 months to run the phase one, get the data, and then we can move on into a phase two. So this is an exciting moment because we're clearing the deck now and lining up our ducks so that we can actually get DMT into human beings and start seeing if it can help people who have had a stroke, so an acute during that stroke or close thereafter, and also in the recovery stage. So those will be the two areas we want to investigate.
Yeah, super important work. Chris, thank you very much. Congratulations on this. And we look forward to following the story, of course.
Okay, talk soon.
All right, there's Christopher Moreau, the CEO of Algernon Pharmaceuticals.